Welcome to the Randy Gravett Leadership Podcast, where we help you lead the hardest person you will ever lead, yourself. Here's your host, someone who believes leadership begins at home, Randy Gravett.
Thanks so much for joining us again for this week's show. Appreciate so much all of you who have subscribed and you've been sharing with your friends. Our numbers are growing. It's pretty cool to see that there's a group of people just like us out there who are trying to lead themselves well, trying to get better at leading the hardest person they'll ever lead. And that is themselves. It really is. The battle is with myself so much. Now this month, we started off last week. We talked about this idea of leveling up. And I'm doing it in the context of just a few weeks left in the year as we begin to think about leveling up. How do we get to that next level before the end of the year? As I mentioned to you last week, if you listen, we've got a really special thing we've been working on that is going to be available in just a few weeks on 21 things to your best year ever. We're going to release it at the beginning of the year. Again, we'll keep telling you about that, but we don't have to wait till the beginning of the year to level up. There's some things we can do that if you think about a staircase in your home or in your office or wherever you are, if you've got a place, you got a staircase, if you just think about just taking one step, pretty soon you end up at the landing, the next level of your home, if you're in a home. Same thing's true with your leadership. There's some things you can do. You can take one step. Next thing you know, you level up in your leadership. Last week, we talked about the power of focus and how it takes us one step closer to where we want to be. Well, there's these few weeks left in the year, we don't want to just mail it in. We really do want to level up. How high can we go before the end of the year? And so today we got a new idea that's going to help us take one more step up. If focus helps us go up one level, I think this one is going to help us as well. And it's the idea of urgency. Urgency. I think it's not enough to have focus. I mean, we have focus all we want to, but we've got to act. We've got to have urgency. We've got to have a bent toward doing something. And as I think about this idea of urgency, I'm taken back to my days in elementary school, maybe even high school. And I think about the homework that was assigned. Now, if you were like me, you had as you got even higher in your education, you know, pretty soon the teachers start giving you this packet at the beginning of the semester or the quarter, whatever system you were on. And there's like, here's all the things we're going to do. And if you want to go ahead and begin to work on these things, have at it, that would be great. But if you were like me, you did not begin working on them the first night when you went home with the packet. In fact, the packet for me would go on a nightstand or on a desk or somewhere in my dorm room when I got to college. And I didn't really give that a lot of thought until I pulled out the little paper that had all the deadlines when things were due. And the same thing was true even as in elementary and high school when I think about homework, this powerful concept of homework. And I say powerful because if it had it not been for this idea of homework, and it really the homework wasn't what was powerful, it was that it was due the next day. Or it was due next Thursday, or it was due on Friday. The fact that you had a due date, that's what caused you to have this sense of urgency. You knew that if it was due, weren't most of us cramming for the test the night before? Or there were times that I was actually, you know, in homeroom studying the spelling words that were, or the definitions that were going to be due later in the morning. And so urgency is a powerful thing in the life of a student, but it's also a powerful thing in the life of a leader who wants to go to another level. Now, think about this. You don't want to hopefully stay where you are. And yet, if you're not careful, there's a barrier to leveling up when it comes to this idea of urgency. And that barrier is complacency. Sometimes we convince ourselves that we've already achieved enough. It's already been hard enough. We've already worked as much as we can. We don't really feel like giving any more, and we get complacent with where we are. When I think about complacency, I always think about an airplane. Now, just a few months ago, I was on an airplane all the time, and I had diamond status on our airline that I always fly with, and so I'm always getting these upgrades. And most of the time, I mean, almost every flight, I would end up in what they call the comfort seats. They're right behind first class. They're really great seats. They're a lot better than the seats in coach. And And yet there were other seats in the plane. And occasionally I get to sit in those seats when they would upgrade me. But I typically didn't sit in the first class seats. Now, the first class seats were always available when I bought my tickets, but I wasn't willing to pay the price. I didn't see the importance of that. I'm hoping for an upgrade, and I'm thinking maybe I'll get up, you know. And so as you begin to think about your leadership, I think this is a good picture of complacency. Sometimes we get into the comfort seats. We're a little bit ahead of some other people, and this idea of comparison comes up, and we start thinking, you know, I'm better than where they are, or I've made more progress than she has, or he's not quite at the level where I am, and or I've got these people on my team and I'm a little bit ahead of them. I remember years ago I was teaching a class and I kind of got thrown into the deep end of the pool teaching a biology class with some high school kids, and I really wasn't trained to do so, but the principal was desperate and she gave me this job, and I remember just trying to stay at one day ahead of the students. And so some of us, we convince ourselves that we're just one little bit ahead of somebody else. We feel good about that. And we become complacent. It's almost like we become content with where we are. Or probably a better way to say it is we become satisfied with where we are. I think we need to be content with where we are if we're doing our best. But I think the best leaders are really not satisfied. They're content because they know they're giving it their best, but they're not satisfied with where they are. And so as you begin to think about this concept and this idea of leveling up with urgency, if you're not careful, complacency can get in your way. It can become a distraction. You can get real comfortable with where you are, how much you've accomplished, and lose this opportunity to level up. In fact, complacency will pull you down a step and will cause you ultimately to level down in your leadership. So let's think about, how do we get that next level when it comes to urgency? I'll give you a couple of things that I think you can actually do immediately to help between now and the end of the year. I would say set yourself a goal. Now, you may be thinking, well, I had goals at the beginning of the year. That's great. What's your goal in the next 45 days? What's your goal in the next 5 or 6 weeks? Do you have a goal? We talked about that priority last week, that focus area. What's your goal in that area? Is it measurable? Is there something you'd say, I'm going to do this many, I'm going to have this way to measure it, and you can set yourself a goal. And I think for some of us right now, the best thing we could do to level up between now and the end of 2020 would just be to freshen up a goal, because some of us have accomplished those goals. We've already ran past the tape, so to say, on those goals. And so we don't want to just coast the next few weeks. We don't want to just be comfortable. We want to go ahead and reach for something harder, something bigger. And so I challenge you to set yourself a goal. Another thing I would encourage you to do is not just have a goal, but to have a milestone. What's going to be your check-in every week on, you know, your progress on those? Maybe you got 6 check-ins every Tuesday or every Thursday for the next few weeks. You're going to check in on those goals or on that goal that you have set. You're going to have some milestones along the way and know that the next couple of weeks I need to get here. 4 weeks from now, I need to be there. And then by, you know, New Year's Day, I'm ready to celebrate just going to the next level here in my leadership. Another thing I would say is give yourself a deadline. This is powerful. It's not just over the next 6 weeks, but anytime you're tempted to be complacent or you're finding yourself losing your sense of urgency, that deadline, the homework is due on this day, at this time, in this class. That was so powerful back then. And it can be powerful for us as leaders who are trying to lead ourselves right now. I want to encourage you to set yourself a deadline. I'm going to get this done by this day. And then there's one more thing you're going to need, and that is what I would just call a friend, you know. And so I'm just going to blanket it with this idea of a friend. But there's so much that you know, almost back in school, you had your study buddy or somebody that you could, you know, learn with. I think the same thing is true here when it comes to our sense of urgency or our goal. If you're not careful, if you grow complacent, you'll surround yourself with complacent people who are not going to push you. Really great leaders are surrounded by really great leaders who are always reaching, always pushing, never satisfied. They're trying to do more because they know their influence is on the line. It's important. So whether your friend is a mentor or a coach or it's somebody you have, your friend down the street, maybe one of your coworkers, a family member. You get to choose, but you're going to need somebody probably to hold you accountable to what it is you're trying to do between now and the end of the year. The homework is due. The homework is due. It is your opportunity to say, I am going to reach for more. I'm going to have this sense of urgency, and I'm going to push on it. Now, let me kind of wind us down here with this idea. Sometimes I think that we get confused. And in fact, we've heard this before, that I think it was Stephen Covey talks about in the Seven Habits, this idea of urgency. I'm not sure if it was him or not, but I think it was urgency versus important. And we get sucked into the urgent and we lose sight of what's important. I'm not saying today that you should be urgent about things that are not important. The things that you should be urgent about should tie back to what we talked about last week, your area of focus. You want to make sure that you are urgent about those things that matter most. Don't be urgent about unimportant things. Don't be urgent about things that really don't matter at all. If you're not careful, you will get urgent about things that actually are distractions. Remember last week we talked about those distractions, those things that get in our way? You don't need to be urgent about those things. You need to be urgent about things that really matter. And your goal should be tied to that area of focus, as we talked about last week, having that one bullseye area in your leadership where you say, I am going to go after this in these next few weeks. If I don't do anything, this is going to be the one thing that's going to matter most. So get urgent about that. It really matters that you conquer yourself in this area. You don't let yourself win. You are actually going to lead yourself. You're the hardest person you're going to lead, but you can win against yourself. If you will focus, you will get urgent. You really do have the opportunity to move up just one level with focus, one level with urgency. And we're going to give you a couple more over the next few weeks. And as you begin to do these things, you're going to find yourself at the next landing spot in your climb toward high performance. And as you do that, it's going to really benefit not just you, but all the people around you. Things will get better for everyone you lead as you maintain your focus, maintain your sense of urgency, you get the homework in on time, you'll really be able to celebrate as we get toward the finish line here in the next few weeks. You got a couple more weeks that I'm going to share some things that are going to help you level up. As I said, I encourage you to continue to lock in on your leadership. Run to remind you, if you don't know about this, on Wednesdays, we do a Coach's Corner where we go a little bit deeper into the Monday episode. So I've got some things I'm going to share with you on Wednesday about urgency. Just going to give you one idea that will help you be able to even take it further than what we talked about today. But you really get to work on this. If you'll put time on your area of focus and you'll get urgent about that and really put some focus time on that every day, you're going to be positioned to, again, go to the next level in your leadership. And that's going to make a huge difference, not just, again, for you, but for everybody around you. So let's level up. Let's keep leveling up. And we can do that by making sure we get our homework in.
Thanks for listening to the Randy Gravitt Leadership Podcast. Please help us spread the word by sharing today's episode with your friends and coworkers. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel on Spotify or through iTunes. You'll find all the links on the media tab at randygravitt.com. Now, let's go apply what we've learned and lead ourselves well. Remember, leadership begins at home.